I say some kind number when we say they one kind from United Nations Children Education Fund, UNICEF, show say Nigeria they lost almost 500 billion naira every year to poor sanitation and hygiene. Health expert as a gather inside Abuja when we say be the nation's capital, show like 22,000 Nigeria people with another 87,000 picking them under the age of 5 when we say that they die every year from diarrhea. For Nigeria to achieve their health target, they must submit all stakeholders when they join the public and private sector when they go collaborate to form better waka.
According to a World Bank report, around 122,000 Nigerians, including 87,000 children under 5, die each year from diarrhea, with nearly 90% of these deaths being directly attributed to water, sanitation, and hygiene. The 2017 Multiple Indicator Cluster Survey. The case is that about 43.6% of children under the age of 5 are moderately and severely stunted due to poor nutrition or recurrent or chronic illness. This, of course, has severe consequences for the educational development of our children. Access to water, sanitation, and hygiene are part of the indices for socioeconomic development of any nation and thus cannot be ignored. The private sector has always been adept and coming up with new technologies and solutions related to development. However, this is the first time that there is a call towards leveraging the capabilities of the private sector in a collaborative manner in light of dealing with inadequate water services globally. The eradication of inequality in water and sanitation cannot be achieved without greater emphasis on private sector.
Only 16% of schools and 6% of health facilities have access to basic water and sanitation services. And that on average, 68% of people living in rural areas only have access to 4 liters of water per capita per day. Moreover, it's the poorest households in Nigeria who are 10 times less likely to have access to basic water, sanitation, and hygiene services in comparison to the richest households. Another important challenge revealed by the WASH norm is that 47 million Nigerians who are still practicing open defecation, which is putting Nigeria now at the unenviable position at the top of the global list, having overtaken it from India very recently. And that the economic implications are that Nigeria loses approximately 455 billion naira annually due to poor sanitation. The statistics are staggering, alarming. So it seems truly to be the right moment to come together in an effort to co-create solutions to tackle the challenges at hand that are affecting the health and well-being of Nigerians and impeding economic growth. There's no doubt that clean water, basic toilets, and good hygiene practices are essential for the survival and the development of children in the world, and especially here, irrespective of their background.